Hello guys, and welcome to another Minecraft video. Nubis here, and
Spurion, did you forget my name?
Oh yeah, Spurion's here too. So we are in our Minecraft server. The little boxes that you see down there, because I hit F9 and Fraps uses the same F9 for something. So we are going to do a quick little tour, just to show off this little server, try to get people interested. At the moment it is a pay-to-play server. You have to pay to get on. We both agreed on at the beginning that we were only going to let 10 free people on, and we did that. But here's the thing: we might let a few more people on here for free, because out of the 10 who said they were going to join, only one or two has really came on. So we got like 3 slots maybe left. Can you clarify that?
Yeah, we've got 3. I think we can do 3.
So, I say a contest, but we'll, more on that later. Alright. So, this is a
spawn. Creepers!
This is a spawn area. Oh, I got quantum boots on this while I'm jumping so high. This spawn area leads to the 4 directions. Nothing's north. Nothing's really south, but our new home and factory or cobble stuff, and east is where all the action is. Let's start at the wheat farm. Alright, now this is our wheat farm. Really? Fucktards? Is that gonna repair itself? I gotta repair itself over here with the redstone and shit. But anyway, what is supposed to happen is you pull the lever and the water turns on. Like so. And then it. I need to go get redstone. Hold on.
How do you get redstone up there?
Creeper blew up on the roof.
Nice!
So I don't know how. There's redstone in there, I don't know how it's gonna handle redstone. Yeah. So. Can you make it daytime, please? Thank you. And creeper heal didn't get that redstone in there, from in there.
Nope. Oh.
Alright, so that's what that switch does. It turns on and off the water. Now we got auto harvesters under there. As you can see, it's auto planting the seeds and stuff. There are 4 platforms, 6 auto planters on each platform. So, and we got just using pipes down there to distribute all the seeds evenly throughout all of them. Now, all the wheat gets thrown into a auto crafting bench and makes bread. So, we got unlimited food pretty much here with 0 maintenance. This is all within the spawn area, so the old system that we had, people could harvest it all they want, they just couldn't plant the seeds. So this kind of throws that around. Alright, let's show, Let's show the, oh, I built this cake because, well, it's my birthday on Monday, and I felt like baking a cake.
Happy birthday, asshole.
Goddamn creeper!
Well, that's not good.
Yeah, tell me about it.
It's fixed.
This is our, one of our power distribution systems. It's using wireless redstone. No? Yes? Wireless wire.
Wireless teleport wires. Or teleport pipes.
Yeah. He's not even remotely done with this. But this is a solar flower. Yeah, it's humongous. And it's not even done. Oh, here's the best thing about these solar panels. You come over here, you insert the ingredients as shown, you hit the button, and it will pop out a solar panel. Or if you hit this button, it will pop out a generator, or if you hit this button, it will pop out a long little battery. And over here, it does pistons, and it goes redstone engines over here. So yeah, we got an automatic auto setup over here. So it's pretty nice. All right, before I show you that room, I have to show you that building over here. This building over here is our community storage. In 1.8.1, red flowers don't spawn, so this is a way to equalize the system.
They spawn, you just have to use bone meal to get them.
No, they don't.
You can use bone meal to get them. Yes, they do.
Oh, really? Oh.
Yes.
Well, if they didn't spawn, this is a way to equalize the system, and we'll just destroy all the yellow flowers. This is community chest area, or anything in this is open for grabs, besides this little tiny room, and because we're using it for our private storage. This is where you got unlimited of everything. And when I say unlimited everything, because of these. Well, he took out one of the timers over here.
I had to borrow a timer.
I'm not going to explain how any of it works. I'm just going to show you the workings of that. Basically, those things up there generate cobble. They break the cobble and send them down the pipe. And from there, all the magic happens. That's all I'm going to say.
That's really all there is to say.
Yeah. Anything left over that it can't fit through those drops down in these pipes. And probably one third. How much of the actual cobble being generated gets sent over there? Do you say?
Over to where?
The recycler.
Well, it depends. Here, I'll just tell them how this thing works. First, it goes into the furnace. If the furnace is full, it bypasses. And then it goes up to a line of five chests that hold just cobblestone, just in case somebody actually wants to build with the stuff. If it can't go in those chests, then it drops down. And it goes over to the other side. On the other side, Tim, if you'll follow me this way. On the other side, it goes through a macerator, which turns it into sand, and then into another furnace, which then turns it into glass. So we've got six chests of smooth stone, five chests of cobblestone, four chests of bricks and slabs, and then we've got three chests of glass, I believe, up there, all of which are replenished automatically. All you gotta do is take stuff out, and don't worry about it, because it'll fill back up. Anything left, and by anything left, I mean stone blocks, brick blocks, smooth stone, cobblestone, glass, or, well, there's never any sand left because that all goes to the furnace, but it all gets sent over to the scrap room.
going to be the next item on this tour.
My beautiful, hellacious, nasty scrap room. Yes.
Creeper, don't.
He likes me.
Now, we built this room. This is the second version of this room. We built this because we wanted more diamonds. A lot more diamonds. And we originally built this because we were running a mass fabricator.
And we found a better way.
Yeah, if you add scrap to the mass fabricator, it goes faster. But at one point, we had enough power to run it, but I'll show you what 12 nuclear reactors do to a place. Yeah. We smoothed out all the edges, but yeah. That's all I'm going to say.
Yeah, it blew up good.
Yeah, coolant system kind of malfunctions, but I still say it was a server error. But anyway, all this does is make scrap. Okay, you can take 9 scrap and turn it into a scrap box, throw it on the ground, and you have a random chance to get in 1 of 20 items, or yeah, 1 of 20 or 30 items. Okay, it's not every item in the game. It's 1 of like 30. 1 of those 30 items are diamonds. Okay? There's 3 different ways to make diamonds. 1, you can do coal dust and make it that way and do a long process.
That's industrial diamonds?
Yep.
And they only work for certain things.
The real diamonds, there's only 2 ways to make the real diamonds. Using a mass fabricator, or dropping scrap boxes on the ground and hoping you get one. Now, you're all looking at this and it's like, holy crap, you got a lot of scrap. What are you going to do with it all? Well, I had an idea.
Well, hold on. Before you go over there, come back down here and show them what happens when there's too many items in the system. When, because every player has, everybody on the server basically has a teleport pipe input into the system. And when there's too many items, they try to go in the chests. If they can't go in the chests, they drop down over here, back into item form, back into obsidian pipe, back into the system, until they either find a spot in the chest or they find a spot in a recycler. There are 12 recyclers in this room. And the wiring and piping was an absolute nightmare. Right now, I've got a lot of the scrap bottled up. You fell down, didn't you? The long way down?
No.
Anyway,
Go ahead.
Anyway, I've opened the floodgate back up to let the scrap through, so we might want to head over to your invention. Because this chest is going to fill up pretty quick.
And I'm going to get there the easy way. And here's our experiment. And that wasn't a camera cut, but it made a really good... Alright, now this is my invention. This is what I came up with. I have my ideas. Alright, now all that scrap gets put in this chest. It gets sucked out of this chest by this auto crafting bench. And it makes scrap boxes. Now these 2 engines, yeah, you gotta have 2 of them. You can actually place 4 engines on a pipe and pump out really, really fast. But anyway, these 2 engines are pumping out as fast as this is making it into a item dispenser. The item dispenser is dropping it into a obsidian pipe and it's getting filtered. Now these are only the items that we want to keep. You're saying, you're keeping single-use batteries? Yeah, you know what? Each one of those single-use batteries store 1,000 EU of storage. And before you say you're keeping them all, 15,000 a year storage right there, instant power. Stick them in anything and you get enough said. Ores are automatically getting put in this chest. And it's getting sent to the rotary macerator, getting turned into dust, and then getting sent over to the induction furnace, getting cooked. Now you're asking, what is this loop? What is this loop? What is this? Basically, this is a filter. One out of every 10 iron gets turned into what is that?
Refined iron. We've got it turned off right now, though.
Yeah, we have it turned off because we need it to refine iron for, or the regular iron for something. But that's what that does. Now, all the dust gets moved over here from over there. And it automatically gets sent over here because this thing makes dust. This thing pops dust too. So we have all of our bases covered. Now, our power is being sent through here. So we'll just cover that later. But anyway, we have decided, since making a diamond out of almost a million EU of energy is really an efficient way and takes up almost two or three stacks of, well, how many stacks of scrap does it take per cycle?
That's a lot.
Yeah.
I think I actually did the math, and because of the way that the percentage chance of getting scrap out of recycler works, you would need like 200 recyclers running full time to keep up with an MFE or with a mass fabricator if it had plenty of power.
And at one point, we did have positive power with the mass fabricator, and we'll have that again, but not right now. So.
And we could empty a chest in no time.
So this thing, it pops it out, makes the item, sorts it. Anything not in here, it gets sent back to the recycler. So we're recycling our recyclables. And this is our good chest. 50 diamonds. Now, 50 diamonds in 20 minutes. Boom. Enough said.
This is, I will footnote this before you guys flame us on YouTube about this being inefficient. We know it's inefficient because it's nine scrap to one box, and then we're recycling that box if it's not what we want. You know what? We have unlimited stone. We have unlimited resources being fed into this. So do you really think we care about efficiency? I don't know. Not at all.
Oh, and we have never cheated. Once, we will never ever cheat. Everything you see here has been built by hand, by mining, and so on and so forth. We're using the tools in the game to accelerate that, but we never spawn any items. We never give each other, we never give any of us items, we never do anything, and so on and so forth.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of automation here, but it's all. But in the beginning, before we automated, we were doing it by hand, and it sucked.
Right. Okay, when all the ingots are done, it comes up in this chest. And then I do something what Spurion hates me doing. I turn them into blocks. So, yeah. We got blocks. We got tons of copper blocks. I mean, tons. I had to move them out. We're not even going to use copper. There you go. So we just moved up here from our old area, so it's not really built yet. We got stuff on the wall. Let me turn it to Negro Fest. That, right there, what you just saw me do, is the only, if you really want to technically call it cheating, that and change it to sun is the only thing we cheat about.
No, we warp around a lot, but that's just because we can.
Yeah, who doesn't? Alright. Now, I'm not even gonna talk about that solar flower. I know it's really, really inefficient. But, who cares? Alright, this is what I'm calling the admin error. Okay, it has a button here, closes the glass. Now you're gonna say, well, people can break into that. No, they can't, because that glass is in the spawn area. So they can break that all they want, and they will never be able to get in this room. So, there's a lot of holes in the ground because I took all the machines that were down there out. So that's why they're all, this place is empty and barren and doesn't have anything. Our beds don't even work anymore, but our spawn's way up there. We got a little melon farm over here. Well, we did before everything dried up. We have a nether portal down here. And down this way is our mine. Down this way is one of the first projects I did. And it was just an simple underground. I want to do something with this, but I don't know yet. But it's there.
It's a slime chunk, isn't it?
Say what now?
It's a slime chunk, isn't it?
What, the arboretum?
Oh, no. I thought you were down here at the bottom.
Oh, no. Yeah, down there, we got a slime chunk. I think there's two or three of them down here. I just haven't... Because every time I see a new slime, I carve out another chunk. So that's that. There's lava pools up here. So, I mean... there's a lot to this. We've been at this for a few weeks now. We haven't always had this server open to everybody. We wanted to make it stable. Right now it's fairly stable. The server is stable and everything's stable. As you can see, I'm playing now lag-free. If you want to take a look at my frame rate, there, 22, that's horrible. Why am I only at 22?
Because you're capped at 30 with preps.
Oh. Yeah, well,
I'm getting 70, so...
I normally get over 300 frames per second if I didn't have fraps on. So let's just say that. And Spirion can testify to that.
I'll testify to that.
When you spawn right here. Just like this. Every time. What else are we going to show them?
I don't know. You want to dump a bunch of items on the ground and show them how bad the frame rate drops?
No. We have been doing a lot of science, and have figured out despite the mod makers calling it complete, bug-free, there are tons of bugs still. You know, some of the things that we're using are beta. And, you know, and some of the mods that we're using maybe not attendant to work with each other, like, and may bring obstacles to us, like, what is it, making 10 buckets and being able to recycle.
Yeah, RedPower, using the RedPower furnace to turn the 10 buckets into iron, we turned off 10 buckets because of it.
Right, so, I mean, we're still exploring, we're still doing everything. We had to turn off wireless wireless
redstone.
Wireless redstone because it was too unstable and did not work. It's probably due to a matchup with a different mod. It's fighting with a different mod or something and doesn't like it. So, and yeah, it's something that would like to have. But you know what? It's nothing that we're going to be worried about. These are people's houses. I'm not going to go on them. That's an invasion of privacy. And we, like, this one says welcome. So, we can go in this one. But, like, that one has no sign on it. We know who it is, but he apparently doesn't want to welcome us in his house, so we're not going to. No stealing, there's no need to. Everything's open to everybody. If you look,
we do use lightweight chest protection, so everybody can lock their chests from other users.
So yeah, so a lot of us, we're gonna get a lot of grief by doing pay to play. We're not gonna get as fast or as strong or some of you making money. We're not gonna have to make money.
No, we're not.
The fee right now is $5. That's a one-time fee. It's going to go up next month or next week. But that's because, well, we don't want to flood the server. The fee is to keep griefers away. Who's going to pay $5 to come and play on a server to grief it to get banned? Okay. One of our members who did pay a fee, if they did something wrong, they're gonna get banned. Okay, if they drop a nuclear bomb, spawn, or grief something, and is generally a bad person, they are gonna get banned. You know, if they break the rules of the server, if you pay or not, you get banned. By paying, doesn't give you any special privileges. It just gives you access to the server. We do have a few pay-to-play members already. They are very happy. Right now, nobody's on because, one, we're recording and not everybody wants to be on, and two, it is late night for everybody. So,
yeah, it's midnight for us, and most of our user base right now is over in the UK. So naturally, it's even earlier for them. But, and by earlier, I mean like really early morning. Most of them, we would like to see more U.S. players just because that's more our time zone, and, well, we opened the server to quit playing with each other, and I know that sounds really bad, but ultimately that was the joke was that we were tired of playing with each other, and we wanted some more people, some more ideas. One of our members, big props to Beast, the guy that made the solar panel creator and the redstone engine machine over here. Man is smarter than I ever wished to be. He does some crazy things with redstone and pipes, and he's got too much stuff in his head. But he's a great guy. And even him, you know, we were talking about if you break the rules, you get banned. As much as we like Beast, if he was to turn on us someday and grief up the server, he would be in the ban bucket too.
And speaking of, our server gets backed up every 6 hours. Or is it every 3 hours?
Right now it's every 6, but that could change at any time. So, you know, if we notice a lot more players, I'm sure the backups will increase just in case.
Right. So, if something happens right now and server crashes and we have to do a revert, we're only reverting 6 hours back. We only had to do that once, and that was due to
instability.
Correct, with red wire, or wireless redstone.
And that, yes, wireless redstone.
And we had to remove it, and so we don't play with that anymore. The only lag maker in the game is too many objects around. You know what? And before you ask, no, I'm not gonna die by jumping that high because I got quantum boots on and quantum stuff on and I take no damage pretty much. But anyway, yeah, that was, a lot of people lost the stuff. I lost about 3 hours, we lost total about 3 hours worth of stuff. I lost, a reactor rebuild. I completely redid our reactor room. So, I lost it. Okay. A lot of people lost stuff, but you know what? Nobody's mad. Because you know what?
The other thing is, the other night when his reactor blew up, everybody expected a server rollback because of the reactor explosion and all the resources that were lost, and me and ZCC here just said, well, we won't do that again. There was no rollback for that.
Right, because, you know, if the server would have did something to cause that, then yeah, maybe there was a rollback. But because I lost a project I worked about 2 real days on, we're going to do a rollback? No. It was because I forgot to turn on the water or forgot to turn off the reactors and it didn't, one of them didn't cool down as fast or something. I fucked something up. I did something wrong. So I'm not going to punish everybody else because I did something wrong. That's just wrong in my books. What else would you like to show them?
I have no idea.
Let's talk about some of the things that we plan on doing. Right now, we are planning and really aiming towards a community power system. Where instead of you seeing everybody's house and their mother's house and their mother's mother's house with solar flowers and stuff on their roof, they get hooked up to our main power grid and we feed them power via solar.
We figured out how to. We've got a mod called Power Converters that will convert the electrical energy of EUs into BuildCraft's power, which then allows us to use teleport pipes to teleport the power and convert it back into EUs. So we don't see a reason not to have a community-driven power plant. And if people want mass fabricators and all that fun stuff, we're going to make it a rule from the beginning that they can't be... that they can have their house and their furnaces and all that good stuff on the community power, but as soon as they drop a mass fabricator, they have to make their own way to power the mass fabricator, because otherwise they're just going to suck all the power out for the entire community. You know, but we've got the scrap room over there, and generally the scrap in the scrap room is just collecting in a chest. Tonight it's not, because we need to replenish our redstone and our diamond resources because of the mass reactor explosion of 3 days ago. And, but normally all the chests under there are unlocked. If you drop something in there and it doesn't make it to a recycler, you can generally get it back. There's a warp. It's a server-wide warp. Anybody can use it to get there. Everybody's got a teleport pipe hooked up to it so they can automatically send stuff they don't want over there so it's not clogging up chests or sitting on the ground causing lag or whatever the case might be. And they can take scrap as they please. You know, it's not like, you know, as admin saying, okay, you guys can give us the scrap, but you can't have it back. No, they can take as much as they want. More will be made. That's pretty much the decision of me and ZCC at this point is, you know, if somebody needs something, I don't hesitate to give it to them because more will be made.
Yeah, like somebody, like another day, yesterday, somebody on the server forgot to put water in their engines and blew up their quarry. They were pissed. They were pissed. They were, because they didn't know what was going on. They just lost 11 diamond. You know what I did? I went back, got 11 diamonds of my own, of our share resources. So my resources are his resources. I got 11 diamonds of ours. And gave it to him. I said, build yourself a new one. Make sure you put coolant. And you know what? We helped him. He was unaware about the coolant of combustion engines on how they really affect. So, you know, we're not all about doing our own thing. If you come on here and you honestly ask for help, or you ask for help, you're going to get it. You know, if you come on here, ask for resources, keep on, and don't want to earn anything, you're more or less likely to get it. But like that guy, he never asked anybody for 11 diamonds. He went and grabbed his pick and was getting ready to go back down and mine diamonds. I told him, no, here, restart your project, and he did. And we'll do that to anybody. We don't care who you are. If you need help, we'll help you. Me and Spirit have been playing since early alpha, and I mean, I almost want to call us experts at Minecraft.
After meeting Beast, I don't think so anymore.
Yeah, but there's always somebody else out there who knows more than us. And you want to come over to the volcano area?
Good thing you had unlimited bricks, huh?
There is a volcano almost going up to sky cloud level here, and I want to emphasize was.
Now, was.
Yeah. Now I'm not done filling it in, but yeah, there's a lot of badness down there now.
We decided to play with some TNT last night. It was all legitimate TNT from gunpowder we'd collected mining, killing creepers, running around, what have you. And we just went to town.
Oh, let me explain the quantum suit real fast so you're understanding how I'm able to jump. Okay, quantum boots lets you jump high. The leggings lets you run fast. The helmet lets you breathe underwater. So, yeah. So, you can do stuff like this. And you swim really fast underwater, too, with the quantum stuff on. And, you see, I will drown at this point, but no, it's going to keep letting me breathe underwater as long as I have energy in my helmet. So,
what's up with our ocean?
Where?
Right here.
I don't know.
That's fucked up. That's cool.
It's a wave. Hey, we got a wave in our ocean. I think Marklo was messing around with something. That's kind of cool.
Maybe. What was he messing around with to make this?
I don't know. It looks like one block got removed from the top.
Yeah, but that wouldn't cause the whole ocean to go funky.
Well, if you do it a couple times, you do. It will. Before I forget, that little tiny, ugly-looking building is a cactus farm.
Sorry, that's a cactus farm that caused a server rollback. I am not kidding you.
Yes, this single cactus farm is the one that caused the server rollback because it dropped so many items out of that chest. There were so many items over here on the ground. You literally got one frame per second, and we had no idea what was causing it until one day I was like, I bet that cactus farm chest is full. So I checked it, and there you go.
Yeah, I personally am a server administrator in my professional life, and the actions of the server that night that we did the rollback were so just out there that I could not wrap my head around what was going on because I'd never seen anything like it. It literally, if you went one block too close to the spawn, you dropped to 0 frames a second and got kicked off the server. So I rolled back and everything was fine until the next morning when ZCC got on and the same thing was happening. And I think that's at the point when he went, fucking cactus farm is full.
Because I kept on going in this little tiny corner and getting frames drops. And I got closer, and at this point I was getting 1 to 0 frames per second. So I was like, it took me 10 minutes to get over in this little fucking thing, and I dropped down there and I picked up an inventory full of cactuses, and I immediately just got my usual 300 frames per second. By the way, don't ask me how I'm getting 300 frames per second, because I'll never tell. I'll tell you
what. You won't even tell me.
I'll tell you what. If somebody donates $500 to me, I will tell you how to get 500 frames per second in Minecraft. I will tell the whole world, but I'll tell you first. But only if somebody donates $500. And if you don't really, and if you still need proof, I will take a video camera, record my screen while I get 300 frames per second. This is a little logo I made. I was bored one night. It doesn't say sand. It says SNN. Sperion and Nubis. Okay, so we have a few spots open in our server, and I want to put a contest out there. We will open up one slot. We'll put anybody who gives us a decent intro a spot on our server.
Now, let me clarify by saying that we're not full. We have plenty of spots for anybody that wants to pay $5 and join us in playing on this fantastic server. We're opening up an extra free slot for somebody that doesn't want to pay and just wants to make us an intro.
Oh, if you don't believe us we're full, not full, I'm going to show you the IP address to the server and the server listing. Oh, snmminecraft.com, one of 200. And our server is way more powerful than 200. We're not aiming to get mass people on here. We're aiming to get a good community started on here and going. We have a really powerful server because me and Sperion are both programmers. I'm a programmer and web developer, and he's a programmer slash system administrator, so we needed a good dev box.
My title at work is DevOps, meaning I am operations development. I'm a server administrator that does development.
Okay, but back to the contest. We will open up, and if we get more than one, I'm not opposed to letting more than one person in here.
Absolutely not.
Let me clarify that. If we get more than one that we like and that we'll use, because we're going to be posting videos on two different channels. My personal and the SNN Minecraft channel. So, if we have two decent intros, then we're good. So, the intro, limited to 10 seconds. I don't want longer than a 10 second intro because I don't know about you guys, but any intro that's longer than 10 seconds, it takes away from the quality of the video. So, limited to 10 seconds. Nubis's Adventures in Minecraft is the title of the first series, and then SMP Minecraft Adventures is the second.
Actually, there's three.
Oh, Sperion is, yeah, so.
And Sperion plays.
Yep, so we need a third one. So, you deliver us those, and if we like them, if we pick them, if we use them, Like, if we get 10 really decent ones, we may not let all 10 of them in. We'll give you all credit. We'll put them on our YouTube channels, and we'll really give you credit. And then we'll pick the best out of the bunch to use for our intros.
Actually, why don't we do this? If we get 10 good ones, we will start a list. As spots open, you will get a spot. You're not all going to get a spot all at once. You're not all going to get a spot at the same time. But if we decide to open, you know, two more free player slots, the next two people on the list get a spot. If we decide to, you know, if you want guaranteed to get on the server in a reasonable amount of time and you really want to play with us, give us $5. It's going to the cost of the server. We're not using it. We're not spending it on ourselves. It's literally going to help pay for the server. So it's not like we're trying to make money, like you said earlier. It's not happening that way, not $5 at a time.
Right, and if we get to the point where we have abundance of money into our account, because I set up a special Google Checkout account, Merchant account, just for this. Now, yeah, we're going to have PayPal in here, but it's going to be a couple weeks for that. But I set up a special Checkout account just for this. I can't even withdraw money from it because the... I'm not even going to say it, but I can't withdraw money from it right now. But all the money that we get from the fees and stuff are going towards the cost of the server. If at one point we get abundance of money, you know what? The server's going to... We're not always going to have fees coming in. So it's going to go towards future cost of the server. Right now, the server's paid for the next 10 years. So we don't have to worry about it. It's going to be... This Minecraft server is going to be here until... frankly, it dies off. This is going to be a long, long time community. Get in while you can. That's all I have to say. Alright, I'm passing over to Spurion.
I really have nothing to say other than... What the hell was up with the Creeper Hill last night?
We got something called Creeper Hill. Creeper Hill. But there's kind of a collision between two mines. You blow up an engine. Here. You blow up an engine and it causes Creeper Hill not to heal.
Come over here in the desert. We'll show them what it does.
And what it does, well, we showed you what it did earlier when Creeper blew up in front of the scrap house. It heals when the creeper blows up. Now watch this. Now it's not going to happen instantly, but it's going to happen. Watch. The server's going to make a fucking liar out of me. Oh, there. You see it? You see it? It's a form of anti-grief. Because there are ways of grief with creepers, and, well, we are making this server as easy to get on and get along with without accidentally griefing your neighbor. So, teleport, like TP, whatever, that works. Everybody has that command, but... You see, Spurion, he asked to teleport me. And everybody can ask to teleport somebody.
Now it's ask if I can teleport to you. It's not ask if I can teleport you to me.
See, I denied his request. Anybody can ask if they can teleport to you. Anybody. So you can teleport around to your friends if you wanted to. We are really building a good community here. We're trying to. But we need your help. We need more players. So, join. Ask questions. We're both here.
And I guess yeah, we're always here.
I guess that's all I have to say.
We do use Mumble for voice communications, and that's open to anybody on the server. There's no special needs. All you need is a microphone. Preferably a headset and a key to press for push to talk. Other than that, you know.
Oh, if you want to hop on Mumble, it's actually open to everybody at the moment. If you want to hop on Mumble and ask us any questions, feel free. Just be warned, if you're going to make a nuisance out of it on Mumble, we do have a Mumble ban list that will easily put you on. But if you want to go on there and ask some questions about the mods and so on and so forth, feel free.
Oh, the other thing, whenever the server updates, because mods are kind of a pain in the ass to find, I update the server every Sunday. It's not an automatic thing. If there's people on, I let them know. You know, most of the people that have been on here know that Sunday is update day. On our website, I make a jar file, or a rare file, a zip file, of all the mods, of everything that I have to change for block ID mismatches, stuff like that. All you have to do is unzip it into your .minecraft folder and install a mod loader and mod loader MP and Minecraft Forge and jump on the server. That's it. All the mods are already packaged for you. I couldn't make it any easier, I don't think, but I can't distribute the Minecraft jar file because that's against Notch's terms of use. Otherwise, I would just distribute it all as one package and say, here's the package for our server.
And we are writing out a lengthy user. We are writing out a lengthy push to talk. a lengthy FAQ on how to do all that manually, just in case you don't trust our jar file, which is completely understandable. You're getting it from a third party, and you can easily download and install these mods yourself. But if you don't do something wrong, if you do something wrong, it's just going to keep on kicking you out. So that's why we make the jar file.
If you do install on your own, I still suggest you get the jar file because it's got all the block ID changes in the config files, and a couple of these mods did have conflicting IDs, and they're not the standard IDs anymore. So if you do it yourself, don't use the zip files that are part of the rare file I create. Just grab the configs because that's going to keep you from using the wrong ID from the wrong block, and then you're going to see things all funny and it's not going to quite be right. So yeah.
Other than that, I think we're done. We're out. We're going to be doing these type of videos. We're not going to be running around like madmen in any of the editors. We're doing that because we got a lot to talk about in here. We'll be doing these type of videos where we show off people's creations and information type videos. Probably, we're not going to do an everyday thing. We're probably not going to do an every week thing. Maybe every other week, or, I mean, who knows?
Well, from now on, I think it'll happen whenever somebody makes something great on the server. So you guys can actually influence how often these videos take place. And if you want to be part of them, we'll gladly record with you on Mumble. It's not a big deal.
Yep, and I'm thinking about moving my Let's Play videos over to this server because I have a single player Let's Play, and it's going great. I like it, but it's kind of getting kind of hard to play it and this at the same time because I want to do so much on this one that is taken away from my time to do the other one. So you may see me doing my Let's Plays on here, which will show off a lot of the server. But, I mean, and you know what? If you do a Let's Play, feel free to do it on the server. More power to you, you know? You advertise the server to your friends by doing it. You give us, you know? And we may, if you're... You want to do another free contest type thing that I just thought about?
What's that?
Anybody who has a Let's Play series who gets, say, over 200 views, has over 200 subscribers, who wants to find a home for their Let's Play videos, give us a ring. You might have a free home.
Yeah, we've got, well, this is really, there's one guy that's got a house way off to the north, in the swamp, because he liked to settle in the swamp. Other than that, this map is wide open at this point. When we first loaded the map, I flew around in creative mode, I know I'm a horrible person, and just made it spawn chunks, or render chunks, create chunks, whatever, so that we'd keep the server load down a little bit more. That's another thing, the server's very powerful, we can house several hundred people, but I like to be efficient, and I like things to run as smoothly as possible. So that's the reason for the extra loading of the chunks. If you go to the website, snmminecraft.com, there's a map of the server in real time. You can see who's online, you can see what they're chatting about, you can see what's going on, you can watch them move around, you can do whatever you want. but like I said, you know, that'll show you, you know, if you're lost in the woods and you don't know where you're going, check out the map. It'll show you where to go. It'll even show you where you're at.
And right next to that map button is the pay button. It takes you to the checkout.
If you do decide to pay after watching this video, and I hope maybe we've, you know, talked some people into it or changed their mind about paying to play on the server. Like we said, it's a one-time payment. It's not a reoccurring payment. It's not a monthly payment. It's not yearly. It's not every 10 years. It's one time. With that one-time payment, if we ever open up more servers, you'll automatically get added to those, et cetera, et cetera. We do kind of have plans for another server if we get enough donations. There's a, not a BuildCraft server, it'll be a vanilla survival multi-world type server, that we've got planned. So, what's it hurt? It's $5, it's the price, it's less than a Big Mac. I know there's McDonald's in every country, so everybody should be familiar with a Big Mac. It's less than the cost of a Big Mac.
And let me tell you a tiny story that I read about pay to play and griefers and all that. I read the story where a guy worked his ass off for a month on a creation, and he left. He left for a month due to real life issues. He came back, all of his stuff was gone. His buildings were griefed. Everything was just destroyed. He asked the admin about it, and they said, well, we don't know anything about it. He asked to get it, at least get something so he can get started again. The admin just said, we don't know anything about it. So his month, his hard work month was erased. So that same guy went to a pay-to-play server. Okay. He did the same thing. But this time he did it on purpose. He left on purpose just to see what was going to happen. Okay. He came back 2 months later. Everything was there exactly how he left it. Down to the scrap of dirt that he improperly placed just to annoy people was there. So it wasn't griefed. It was... Think of it more as a security thing. Because we are not going to have that many... I mean, if we do have a griefer, we have so many security measures in place that... what harm are they going to do?
That and the fact that we never sleep and we're damn near always on the server.
Yeah, I work from home, and Spiron can...
I work whenever I want.
And even that, he has, we both have mobile admin on our phones, so we can ban people remotely from our phone when we're taking a shit in a restaurant somewhere.
So the thing is, part of being a member of the server, I personally will give you my Skype ID. I will also give you my personal email address. I get both of them on my phone. If you want to message me, you want to call me, you want to email me, I don't care. Middle of the night, middle of the day, same difference to me. Go ahead, find somebody on the server grief and let me know. They won't be here long.
And I would love to do that to me, but I don't always have access to my phone or my internet. So, I cannot. But I will give you my information for when I do get access to it. So if one of us is not responding, the other won't. I think we're going to end the video here. But send us a comment on this if you're interested. Send me a PM. Send me your suggestions. Just comment. Just do what you do. Just give us feedback. Because I know the mines are. There's not a single server out there right now that has the combination of mines that we have on here running as smooth as we have it running. And
Well, Industrial Rage might give us a run for our money.
But even then, they don't have the train mod. They don't have the train mod. They don't have.
Oh yeah, we do have the rails mod, don't we?
Yeah, we haven't even explored that mod yet. They don't have the they don't have the power converters.
They probably don't have red wire either.
Nope. So, like we are very unique. We are our primary mission statement. If you really want to have a mission statement, is to provide the tools you need to make anything creatively that you want to.
The other thing is, the other day when our first couple of users joined, I had mods lined up, I was ready to go, you know, we thought the server was ready. They joined and I missed a few add-ons to those mods. Sunday rolled around, it was update day, I went and found the newest versions, I tested them locally. Test updates locally before I put them on the server. It makes things easier on everybody. You know, it's less headache for me. You guys don't have to update 6 or 7 times because I messed something up. And the downtime is very short. You know, I think the server Sunday was down for something like 20 minutes, which is nothing considering I updated every mod on the server. I added mods. I added add-ons to mods. You know, because people ask for them, you know, like the electric tree taps. They're part of the more tree taps add-on to IndustrialCraft, I believe. And one of the guys on the server said, hey, why don't you guys have this? And I said, good idea. And then another guy asked for wireless redstone. And we tried it. It didn't work. We got rid of it. You know, it wasn't a big deal. But had I not tested locally, had I not, you know, made everything easy, I can't say that those guys would have stuck around for a 3-hour downtime while I tested everything on the server and changed the map and what have you. You know, it's not the way to do things. So, being a server admin in real life, I kind of take things into account. You know, if Sunday rolls around and there's no updates to any of the mods or add-ons, I won't update. You know, you'll have a full, just an extra full day of playing Minecraft. If there are updates, I let everybody know 15 minutes ahead of time that I'm starting the update process, meaning that's 15 minutes before I download the first mod to start getting it working locally. Not 15 minutes before I take the server down. No. I give them another 15-minute warning when I say, all the mods are working, I've got it working locally, I'm going to start updating in 15 minutes. Then they know, hey, I've got 15 minutes before the server goes down for downtime today. It'll be back up in 15 or 20 minutes. Everybody's happy. It's a win-win situation.
So, like, I hope this is a good informational video because we know what we're doing. We're not pretending to be somebody who we're not. We're not pretending not to know what we're doing. Or pretending we really do know what we're doing.
Creeper. That's the other thing. The creeper heal add-on doesn't like pipes. It doesn't like redstone. It doesn't like panels from RedPower. It only likes vanilla Minecraft blocks. So if you blow up a creeper in your machine room and it blows up all your pipes and machines, you've got to replace it all. And it really kind of sucks.
If we're on and it loses, say, a diamond pipe,
you know, we'll give you a diamond.
Right. Now, let's clarify that. We'll give you one from our private storage. We do not use the spawn command. We will never use that command.
Well, clarification. We will. We have But it was when we figured out that wireless redstone didn't work. We had people that made a bunch of wireless redstone receivers and transmitters, and I said, you bring them to me, I'll give you the redstone and the iron back. It wasn't, you know, I didn't feel it was necessary to give them the redstone and iron out of my private stash, because it wasn't their fault that they made the things and they didn't work. It wasn't my fault that we couldn't test it on a bigger scale when I was testing locally by myself. So I spawned redstone and iron. I added up how much redstone and iron was in each one that they gave me, and I gave it back to them. That's the only time that we will ever use the spawn command, is for things like that. And really, I wasn't spawning items. Those items had already been found, they'd already been collected, they'd been made into something else, and I was just breaking that something else down to make sure that those blocks were destroyed, so when I removed the mod from the server, it didn't cause problems. So while we say we don't ever use commands, there are edge cases like that where it's very easy to see why we did it. Other than that, though, in normal play, we don't use them. You know, if I need a diamond pipe and I'm one short, I'll go make a diamond pipe. If I don't have any diamonds, guess who's getting out their pickaxe and going and finding diamonds? This guy.
So there it is. I don't know about Spurion on how he's going to do it, but I think I might start a tutorial on how to do machines and pipes like this, because
I am the pipe master.
He is the pipe master, I am the power master. I know my power, he knows his pipes.
I have a full inventory of pipes right now. I have any pipe anybody could want on me right now.
Not to say that I can't hold my own with pipes, I just, when I do something, I tend to, hey, come here, check this out. Is this,
you overcomplicate things.
Like, I made this whole machine here, and the only thing I had he changed is I had a chest between the dispenser and that. Have you ever noticed, I don't know if that's on purpose, it has a face on it.
Yeah, I've noticed that before.
But I had a chest, they removed it, and voila.
Just like you didn't have a chest back here on the crafting bench, but the crafting bench can only hold, well, in this case, 9 stacks of scraps. The chest can hold a whole lot more, and the automated crafting bench will pull directly out of the chest as soon as the items are available. So you can craft a whole lot more from a chest than you can just from the bench.
Right, so, I mean, this area down here is going to expand as we need it. In the end, I say our whole entire basement is going to be this type mess.
It was a filler, but we used it as a clear to clear out a big area underground where the nuclear blast was. Actually, it was more to straighten up the walls of the nuclear blast, but it also cleared out of a rather large area. I think CCC is going to be building a new reactor down there. I'm probably going to add on to said area to build a redstone pipe machine type test chamber. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. I personally am not big on big buildings or big build projects. But, like, the scrap yard, as I like to call it, the building with all the recyclers in it that makes scrap, took me, the better part of a day to figure out how to pipe it and wire it and make everything work. And that's really the end of my patience for a while. Like, I won't build another big project for probably a week. I'll just run around helping ZCC with his or Beast with his. You know, it's not that I'll be online. I just won't personally be building. You know, I'll have pipes and redstone and blocks on me, so if somebody's short, I'll give them pipes or whatever. But for the most part, I won't build for a while just because my brain is completely fried, A, from work, and B, from doing this.
Okay, so we talked for about an hour.
Yeah,
information. You know what? It's up to you if you want to join a fresh server. We are 2 weeks in. 2 weeks in. That's how fresh the server is. Now, when 1.9 comes along, We will not upgrade our server until 100% of the mods are supported. So, if you're planning on joining, you really want to jump into 1.9 the second it comes out.
Back up your folder.
Yeah, because we will not be upgrading until we can fully upgrade. And that's all I have to say. I'm Nubis, aka ZC Cool.
And I'm Spirin.
Later.